Hi, my name's Aaron Powell. I'm a Principal Cloud Advocate here at Microsoft. And in today's video, we're going to have a look at a couple of demos of how we can use the different kinds of variables in JavaScript. Let's start off by declaring some variables, and we're going to use the different keywords. We'll start with the var keyword for declaring a variable. I'm just going to create a variable. We'll call it hello, and we'll assign it hello as a string. And then if we do console.log, and then provide it with the name of the variable, I hit save on that file, and then run this on our console, node demo.js, we will get, as we expect, the variable to be output, and it comes out with the string hello. Now, something we need to be aware of with the var declaration for variables is that this is a function scoped declaration, and that's important because it changes how that variable is available. Now, while it might not be clear from this file that we have a function scope here, we have a function scope inside of this file that's just implicitly put there by our Node.js runtime. So we can think of this file as one giant function that's being executed, and that's the scope in which our var variable is defined. Now with a var variable, because it's defined using a function scope, it's always available with inside of that scope. So I've just moved the declaration down to line 3 instead of line 1. And if we were to now run this from our console, we would get the output of undefined, which kind of makes sense if you understand that this is a function scoped variable, because the variable is actually defined with inside of this whole function scope, not just from the point that you've used the var keyword to declare it and forward on. So our variable is available on line 1 when we did our console.log statement. We just haven't assigned it a value, so it's implicitly undefined. Now, this is different to when we have block scope variables such as let and const. So let's have a look at let. Let is a block scoped variable that works similarly to the way that we can work with var, in that we can actually reassign it. Actually, let me just move our line down and show you what I mean by reassignment. So I've output initially with hello, and then if we'll change our hello variable to be hello world, and then we were to do our console.log statement. Oops, if I could spell console correctly. There we go. Now, if we were to execute our code again, we would see that this does output the two things as we expect, hello and hello world. Now, we've reassigned this variable, and we can do that with let, but let is going to be block scoped. Let's create a block, and we'll just do an if true statement. So this is just going to always be an executed if condition because it's always going to result in true. And inside of here, we'll do let world equals hello world. And now if we do console.log of world, save our file, and then rerun, we should end up with the second hello world output as we were expecting because this variable has been defined and it's available for use. Let's now move that upper line. So now we're declaring it, we're attempting to use it before we have declared it. So we'll save our file, execute from the command line. This time, we've received a runtime error. The reference error cannot access world before initialization. That's because we've tried to use the variable before we've initialized and declared that variable. So this is something that will happen at runtime if you try and use a let keyword to create a variable and then use that variable before you've actually defined it. Also, because this is only available with inside of the block scope, if I was to move the console.log statement to after the closing curly bracket, which is where our block ends, and execute the code again, we will get a different runtime error. Now, world is not defined. That's because it's no longer with inside of the scope. We've moved out of the scope where that variable was initially declared, the block scope, and we can't use that variable, or we can't access that declaration of that variable. This is similar to how the const keyword will work. Const works like world, works like let, not world. That's the name of our variable. So const, we'll create it and we'll just give it a name. We'll call it Aaron and we'll give it my name. Now, if I was to do console.log Aaron, we would get, as we expect, the output in our console. So we'll get that variable output. Being a block scoped variable, if I was to put this inside of a block like I did with our let bound variable, then it would be only available with inside of that. So, but that's the thing that is in common between let and const. But the other thing that let has going for it that const doesn't have is the ability to change. If we were to try and change the variable, so let's try and change Aaron to Aaron Powell, so my full name, and then run our code again. Now we're going to get a different runtime error. Sorry, that's obscured a little bit. Let's just bring it up again. Run it so you can see it from behind my head. Here we go. Now we've received an error saying that the assignment to a constant variable has happened, and that's a type error. This is because we've attempted to assign a const. We can't assign a const because it's a constant. It's the value that was originally assigned to it is the value that will always be assigned to it. So now, if you want to use a variable declaration, you've got the choice between const, let, and var. Const is the one that I would recommend you use most frequently because this helps you as the reader of your own code and other people reading your code understand that the variable you've defined should only be used once. And that's the time that you want to be using it and that you can't reassign it. A let bound variable will be useful though still inside of specific blocks that are being reused, such as a loop block, like a for loop or a while loop and things like that. That time you might want to use a let bound variable instead of a const bound variable because you need to be able to change the value for each iteration of the loop. There's very few reasons why you would need to use the var keyword though, because as a function script variable, its availability is increased exponentially, but also it has some challenges around when that variable is available. As we saw initially, we can accidentally use it before we've even defined the variable, which can be quite confusing when you come back and look at it later. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.